breathing techniques and rituals are not necessary when you do this. They're not necessary when you do this. Breathing techniques and rituals are not necessary when you do this. My name's Peter. I'm on the Productivity Academy, which has Ki Gong School. We've got online courses. We've got the Dream Method, which is a one-to-one coaching course. Many different things. But today I want to talk about breathing techniques and rituals, which are actually part of the online courses. If you do this, you won't need to do that. Breathe deeply all the time. it sounds easy, right? But it's not, because our mind affects our breathing, our body affects our breathing, our state of finance, whether we've got stress on us because of financial problems or other issues, emotional issues, or chemical issues in our environment, or eating or drinking, chemical issues. All of these cause stress in the body, which will make your breathing shallow. And this really starts to ingrain itself into the subconscious, so the breath gets more and more shallow. And this is not good for you, or your health, or your well-being. My finding out we had a lot of work with the elderly, or some charity group of Brighton Living, to help the elderly with their health and well-being using Ki Gong and breathing techniques, I see enormous improvements within weeks of them just doing the simple exercises and rituals and the tips, and they take that into their everyday life, and they just remember every day just to check in on their breathing. So they don't need to do a ritual that they sit there for 20 minutes or whatever, 5 minutes, 2 minutes, 1 minute, whatever you do. They can do that because they're doing it regularly in the class. They're not having to stick to the rituals. Yeah, they do the rituals every now and again. But you don't have to do that if you're really focusing on your breathing. And it takes time. And it's brilliant, of course, which I'm sure you will. So it won't take you much time. But you've got to keep coming back to your breath. Your breathing breath. Your breath is your life. Your breath is your gateway to your consciousness. Your consciousness and your breath are really interlinked. So the more you're breathing deeply, the more your body's in this parasympathetic nervous state, the more your body is receptive for new energy, the more energy you will receive through your pineal gland. Really simple stuff, but it's important to realize that when you're living in this crazy world that we live in, it's very chaotic, very difficult to live in, and it's time we stopped cutting ourselves off from the energy that we should be receiving. And how do you do that? By breathing deeply. It's really simple. That's why so many people are sitting on the sides of mountains like the Tibetans and all the Buddhas and the Buddhists and all the Vedic scholars. They're all sitting there doing breathing deeply all the time, pranayama. So you can do this yourself. You can learn to breathe deeply. If you want help with it, which I did, I'm saying I didn't, but I did, you can click the link below, go to a free breathing course. It'll tell you a little bit more about what I'm saying now, give you a little bit more information. Also, a few breathing techniques to get you quicker into where you want to be. And there's a second course on top of that, if you want to go a bit deeper with it, so that you learn. Your mind becomes knowledgeable about what breathing does for you, so that you keep coming back to it. It's a reminder. You go, oh, I'm not breathing deep enough at the moment. Remind yourself. It becomes part of your self-discipline to help you get the life that you want. It's really important. Tuning in to your heart vibration. That's what I say in the conscious music collective. It's tuning in to your heart vibration. And you do that through breathing. Ki Gong is a fantastic way of doing it because you're doing it movement with your breath. You learn to move in a relaxed manner so that you're always relaxed until you have to run or fight or whatever you need to do to get out of danger.